Second. of our hearts, O Lord, to prepare the way for your only Son. By his coming, give us strength in our conflict and shed light on our path through the darkness of this world. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Thank you. efforts he's done, while this is inflammable. And that's the word of God. Father, prepare the way of the Lord. Make strength last. All mankind will see God's salvation. Thank you. So while John proclaims the law, he does force that can trust that God has chosen us in all of our ugliness because God does it for us. The Lord has destroyed it because the work that we still have. And the people who said this is not the best of time is because they want to just carry us. The purpose of every proclamation of God's law is that the heart within both the twisted winding passages is strength. That the heart which rebels and faith and despise their Lord is humble and false to see their desperate need for sin. Fire focus of God's law is to show us how desperate we need it. And so this proclamation of this cross is one that does not want to see us, but instead wants us to receive forgiveness, salvation, life. That's why he sent men like John, or any of the other prophets, or apostles, or pastors, or teachers, or even brothers and sisters in our lives, Christ, to have to call us to repentance. Because our Lord does not want us. He desires to be with us for eternity. Of the body and the life of the last. fun throughout the centuries and defeated in the terms of fun. To set the offspring of the woman to first respect for your profitable multi continually directed the eyes of your people to the essence of the thing. We praise you for keeping your promise and sending your son to destroy the world. As we prepare to celebrate the birth of our king, use your mighty word to scatter our flames and to rouse us from spiritual slumber. Sent your son to redeem us with you. Let this good news be our joy this Christmas. Use it to cheer the hopeful, encourage the fearful, and give hope to the despairing. In these days before Christmas, spare us from the stress and deadline in the frenzy of our responses. Fill our lives with the message of your grace and the use of your grace. Direct our lives not only to the manger, but also to the skies, where we will see your son from heaven, not as a lowly child, but as the Lord of hosts. Lift up our hearts in joyful anticipation of this day. Hear us, Lord, as we bring you most of our time. Almighty God,